Hello and welcome to this video. Momo1404 is the opponent. Do we have a... Okay, no, it goes for c5. It's not a very common move order. Let's see. So, ultimately, we probably get an anti-IQP position out of this slightly uncommon move order. Let's see what he plays now. Here black has a choice. This is pretty uncommon. I wonder. I can probably play this as a simple solution. I take first on c6. I don't know. Probably not a big deal. He will take on d4 now, I guess. No. Okay. I can play various things, but I should not invest too much time. Black is attacking d4 twice, but taking on d4 looks pretty insane. So, I mean, taking once is certainly okay, but not twice. All right, so this is what I was thinking of, that I want to wait until he plays this. He takes with the queen. Okay, I give up. I can never guess any of his moves. I thought bishop takes looks normal. Okay, queen takes, it's not terrible. Just not a move that I expected. So, knight takes d5. He somehow has queen takes, yeah. Queen takes b5. Yeah, guess so. Okay. Interesting. I could try to put this bishop to b3 to put more pressure on the pawn. What about my bishop on c1? Bishop d2 looks a little bit wrong. Bishop d2, even d4 seems feasible. Black's position is maybe not so bad. It's a little bit weird, what, I mean, at least in my eyes, what he played, but don't see anything convincing now. So bishop d2, there is d4. I don't know. Let's put this on a safe square. Attack d5. Rook d8 now, I guess. He can go d4 and is certainly okay. What I wanted to do is here with bishop f1 to go out of this fork. Like on b5 it would be a fork. Now at least this is not a fork. I don't have a great square for the queen though. Queen g3, this bishop to d6 or knight f5. Queen d3 is also not looking good. Don't know, not happy. I have the bishop pair in an open position, but currently my coordination is really not so good. Wouldn't mind the queen trade. My queen is not really finding a good square, so I think he should... Yeah. But where is he going? Queen to b6 or to b4, I guess, but it doesn't look particularly attractive. Queen b4, there is knight d5. At least. Queen b6 can be played, but then bishop b3 looks awkward. Yeah, that's probably not so bad for me. I can enter that pre-move in case he decides to take. No. Okay, so rook c1, yeah. Bishop e3, there was... anyway, I have to be a little bit faster. So queen h4. Knight f5, queen a4. And finally, I have arrived on a light square where I'm not getting attacked all the time. And now I have knight b5 or knight d5 as threats. He has to do something about that. Okay. It's a double attack essentially on the queen and the knight, so a trade seems likely, but trade seems also okay for me. So this one, it's attacked. So cover the pawn or save the pawn. Yeah, he definitely has active pieces here. The knights are active. Okay, bishop e1. It's kind of normal, but this one, it's a bit, that's not costing so much time. B6, I go to e1. G4, bishop g2 would be nice. Or bishop d3 is also a useful move. I also threaten g4 now. If the knight moves, there's knight e7. Yeah, that position looks okay in my mind, but the 11 seconds are a little bit concerning. That looks wrong. That looks wrong. I know. F3, there's rook c5 somehow, but I'm still winning stuff here, like this. This is probably easier, at least if he has a bishop I cannot stumble into a fork. And now you put everything on light squares, and that is a simple technical task, because then the bishop is not attacking anything ever. Okay, so that was tricky, somehow very tricky, a tricky position. Bishop g4 looks really a little bit loose in my mind, but I couldn't quite prove that. So, okay, I played h3, this, and queen to b6. Yeah, that seems like this looked fine, and maybe I have some room for improvement here. Yeah, this is an interesting engine suggestion. I think the point is that this is probably good. If we look at this, and now I should probably have a good game with bishop b2, rook c1. I already have some pieces traded, which emphasizes the weakness of those pawns in the long run. That could be true. And if queen takes, I get a better version basically of the game. And the pawn is reasonably weak. Yeah, I have rook d1 coming. Again, there are two sets of minor pieces traded, which is favorable if you play against the IQP. It's nothing terrible, but I'm comfortable. This seems better than the game. In the game, I really had problems to prove anything at all. And particularly here, yeah, I spent like more than a minute, which is completely crazy, actually. But the problem that I saw is bishop d2 is what I wanted to play, but d4 was concerning. Yeah, bishop c6. I thought he can take here, but I can actually take there, right, on b7. Okay. No, that I did not understand that. That this is good for me. I thought like d4 is a problem because takes, knight takes, that looks, looks wrong. And this is just like conservative chess, bishop f1. I don't think I have a problem. It's a little bit uncomfortable. Knight b5. Yeah, that looks a bit stronger, maybe. Queen b7, I did not consider. It felt wrong to me to spend even more time in this position with the queen. So, queen g5. And now I feel I'm probably a little better. Yeah? That's actually what the engine confirms. Like this. Nothing special, of course. Queen b6, queen b5. Takes. This is still okay. And then somehow he's losing the thread here. This. Maybe a6, yeah. Knight c7. Yeah, you should. Maybe you should take, but that's not really what you want to do. Here it gets difficult. And now king h7. Okay, king h7 clearly was a big mistake, yeah. And here I'm just winning material. It's too much happening on that diagonal. There's too much happening. f3, and then here. That is winning. Bishop takes. I think the engine also. I would be able to. I can do that, okay. And then. Yeah. Okay. But what I did is fine. And here, I think it's easier. Just a little. A piece of blitz advice. It's easier here to play against the bishop than to play against the knight. I mean, this is also, of course, winning, but it's easier if you want to make. I have enough time, but if you need to make many moves, it's much easier to have this than with the rook. Everything is on light squares, and the bishop is just never ever attacking anything, and with the knight it's always jumping around and can be irritating, and this is much easier this way. Yeah, thanks a lot for watching.